In order to figure out the forces developed in the three cards holding a 25 kg flower pot at point A in an equilibrium position, we can start by drawing a free body diagram of point A and list down all the forces that are developed in the ropes, and then apply the equilibrium condition to solve for the unknown forces. So to start, let's go ahead and draw our free body diagram by placing the origin at point A. Next, we list down all the forces developed in each force. Since we already know the weight of the flower pot acting vertically downward, we can define it as a variable W that can be calculated by multiplying 25 kg with 9.81. Next, the force developed in the rope from A to B can be given as FAB. Similarly, the force developed from A to D and A to C can be listed as FAD and FAC. Next, let's go ahead and solve our force FAD in terms of Cartesian vector form. So typically, if a system is three-dimensional, it is better to solve that system in a Cartesian vector form. And once we have all its I, J, and K component, we can combine them to figure out our resultant forces. So to start, our FAD is making a 30-degree angle with a line that lies on the ZY plane. Taking the cos function, will project our force along that line. Next, if I take the sine 30 function, it will project it along the positive X axis. Now, once we have our force FAD cos 30 that is still lie along the ZY plane, it's further needs to be resolved along the Y and Z axis, which can be done by taking the cos 30 function that will project it along the negative y direction. Whereas if we take the sine 30 function, it will project our force component along the positive z direction. Now, once we have listed down all the forces on our free body diagram, let's go ahead and write it in terms of the Cartesian vector form. So here, the FAD force vector can be represented as FAD sine 30 I, where I is a unit vector showing the direction along the positive X axis. Next, I have FAD cos 30 times cos 30. Since it's acting along the negative Y direction, that's why it is given as minus J. And finally, I have a component of FAD going vertically upward. So we have positive FAD cos 30 and sine 30 K. Now we can go ahead and simplify this. So we have our form of FAD as 0.5 FAD I minus 0.75 FAD J and plus 0.433 FAD K. Now, once we have the force vector FAD, we can go ahead and repeat this process for all the forces here. So let's go ahead and move next to FAC. Now, FAD and FAC are quite similar. The only difference between them is the X component of FAC is in the negative direction. So let's go ahead and redraw our components of force FAC along X, Y, and Z axis. So to start, we will repeat the same process. First of all, FAC can be projected along a line on our ZY plane by taking the cos 30 function. And as you can see, it is directed towards the Z axis here. Now this component needs to be further divided and we'll do that in a minute. But let's do the sine 30 function, and it is projecting along the negative X direction. So this component can be written as FAC sine 30. Now for the component that lies along our YZ plane, it will again be projected along the negative Y direction and positive Z direction. Now we are taking the cos 30 function. In order to figure out the angle 30, we have utilized the rule for triangle, the sum of the internal angles of a triangle is equals to 180. Since we were given the angle 60, and the angle between the z-axis and y-axis is 90 degrees, so our third angle was 30 degrees. So we can go ahead and take the cos 30 and sine 30 function to project that vector along the negative y and positive z-axis respectively. Next, let's go ahead and write these down and simplify this thing. So our value of FAC vector will be negative FAC sine I. Now here the negative sign is indicating it is going towards the negative x direction. Then we have minus FAC cos 30 cos 30j, as it is also going in the negative y direction. And finally, I have a positive FAC cos 30 times sine 30k. Simplifying, we get our value of FAC as negative 0.5 FACI minus 0.75 FACJ and plus 0.433 FACK. This is the Cartesian vector form of our force FAC. Now let's go ahead and look at our final chord from A to B. Now this chord, if you look, it is on our y and z plane, so it will only have the component along the y and z axis. Now since we are given the angle 45, this chord is making from the vertical z axis, and by knowing that the sum of three internal angles is equals to 180, and since the second angle is 90 degrees, so the third angle will be 45 degrees. So we can project this force along our positive y-axis by taking the cos 45 function, whereas we can project our force FAB along the z direction by taking the sine 45 function. Since both are going in the positive y and positive z direction, so our final FAB Cartesian vector form will be FAB cos 45j plus FAB sine 45j. And we can simplify this thing as well. That will give us our value of 0.707 FABJ plus 0.707 FABK. Now, since we have listed down all the forces in the Cartesian vector form, let's go ahead and represent our weight of the flower pot in the Cartesian vector form as well. To do that, since it is acting in the downward direction along the z axis, so the value of W will be negative 25 kg times 9.81. Here, we have to remember that we are given the mass of the flower pot and we have to convert it into the weight, that is a force. So since we will be doing summation of forces, we want to make sure that we have to convert the mass into the weight, and that is coming as negative 245.25 kg. Now once we have listed down everything, let's go ahead and apply our equilibrium equation, that is summation of forces should be equals to zero in order for the system to be in equilibrium. So to start, we can do summation of forces along the x direction equals to zero and add all the I components together. So in this case, we have just two forces that have the I components, and they are basically equal in magnitude and opposite in direction. That give us our FAD is equals to the force FAC. So two ropes will have the same force in this system. Next, we can go ahead and apply summation of forces along the y direction equals to zero. And in this case, I have three of the forces that have the y component j. So do that. Let's add everything together. I have negative 0.75 FAD minus 0.75 FAC. But since FAC is equals to FAD, we can replace that to have a simplified form. Finally, I have 0.707 FAB equals to zero. Let's go ahead and simplify this thing. So we are getting 0.707 FAB is equals to 1.5 AD, which can be further simplified to give us a value of FAB in terms of FAD. Now, once we have our second equation, we can go ahead and write our final equilibrium equation, that is summation of forces along the z direction and equate it equals to zero. So in this case, all the force components, the rope that we have a component along the z direction. So let's go ahead and add them together. Now for the force FAD and FAC, I have the same component. And since both of these forces in the rope are equal, we can just multiply them with 2 and have a single value of 2 times 0.433 FAD plus 707 FAB, and we can replace FAB in terms of FAD as well, that is 2.12 FAD, and finally minus 245.25. Simplifying, we get our value of FAD as 103.7 Newton. Now, once we have this, we can go back and look at our equation where we are equating summation of forces along the x-axis equals to 0. That means our FAC is also equals to 103.7 Newton. And finally, place it in the second expression and get our FAB as 220 Newtons.